into the mirror. Feel a little better now. Everybody wants to tell someone their secrets. Why don't you tell me now? Well, maybe I can fix this, 'cause I don't want you to miss this. And the sun is
a lot of format changes. American Idol, they've even lowered the age. What do you think about that? Do you think that's fair?
I mean, it is what it is. You know, if there's, you know, 14-year-olds that are prepared to, or whatever it is, 15, 14.
15 now, yeah.
If they're mentally prepared for it, then yeah. But like, I mean, I was barely mentally prepared for what it was, and I was, you know, 23. So, I mean, I understand why, you know, they want to go after that Justin Bieber, that pop star, and I get it. But I think there's some rules that are pretty stupid. I'm not a fan of, you know, taking the instruments out of the hands of the contestants. I'm never a fan of that.
Yeah.
That's, you know, if that's what you do, that's what you do. And there's been some different changes. Like, they have in-ears this year, I saw. Mm-hmm. They have in-ears, like, so they can hear themselves.
Yep.
That would have been nice.
And they seem to have been styled from the get-go as well. Like, everything just seems, they seem to be giving them more from the beginning.
Yeah, and that's awesome. I mean, good for them. But there's just some subtle changes that I think are great and some that I'm not so thrilled about, you know, like the instrument thing. I'm not a fan of that. I mean, if you're an artist, let them be an artist. Mm-hmm. Let them play. You know, they like to say, you know, they hide behind their guitars. I think the producers were complaining that they were hiding behind their guitars. I think that's ridiculous, you know. I think if you're an artist, you know, you do what you do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you play the guitar, if you play bass, if you play... Look at Casey Abrams, you know, this year. He was an awesome bass player, you know, jazz, blues bass player. And, I mean, I don't think he was hiding behind his bass at all. I think that's what he does. You know, I play the guitar and sing. There's no reason for me not to play the guitar. That's what I do. But, hey, you know, I don't make the rules.
So, for you, are you watching this current season of American Idol 10?
When I can. You know, I've been pretty busy lately, flying around and all that. But, I mean, I've definitely been keeping tabs on it, yeah.
Okay, so for you, what have been so far the most shocking moments? And there have been a few.
I'd say, you know, to name a couple of them, I think Casey, when he got voted off so early and they saved him.
Yeah.
That was kind of iffy for me. I was like, that didn't make any sense to me.
Wait, do you think, though, touching upon that, do you think it's because people at home were like, oh, other people are going to vote for him, so we don't have to vote for him?
I don't know. I don't know how he got sent home. To be honest with you, it doesn't make any sense to me, because he was definitely a fan favorite, and he was killing it, you know? Mm-hmm. So I don't know how that happened, and I think Pia going home.
Tragedy.
She was, I'm not going to say she was the best singer on the show, okay? Everyone's their own individual, you know? But come on. Like, she was ridiculous.
Yeah.
And
she was the whole packet.
To see her go home, I was just like, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, so, I don't know. You know, sometimes people vote for whatever reasons. You know, whether it's the girls voting for a guy because they think he's cute, or whether it's the guys voting for a girl because they think she's cute. You know, whatever the reason is, you know, I would hope the reason's always based around the vocal and, like, what someone's into. Like, don't just vote for who you think's the best singer. Vote for who you want to go see in concert. Go vote for the person that you want to go buy their album. That's the person you should be voting for. And, I think those two moments for me were kind of like, you know, head tilters. I was like, really? They're sending Casey home? Like, it was just an odd moment for me.
Regardless of who's in the top three or who is actually going to win, who do you think should have won out of everybody that was on this season?
That's a tough one. I think there's several people that should or could have won this season. I think Pia could have easily won. I think Casey could have won. I think Paul could have won. I think Haley could win. I think Scotty could win. And I think I think James could easily win. But right now, I mean, I think like if I had to pick like my personal musical tastes, mm-hmm. it'd be like somewhere like between Casey and Haley. You know,
okay.
those would be like my personal like musical tastes. But I think anyone can win, and I think that you know they were all talented. That's why they were there. Mm-hmm. You know, so it'll be exciting to see who wins. But Scotty is, you know, you gotta watch out for that guy too. I mean, he'll be doing something in music no matter what it is, whether he wins, doesn't win. But he'll be around.
So for future contestants out there, what would you suggest to them to help them to connect with the audience? Because really, the connection to the audience is what causes that person on the other end to pick up the phone and dial those
numbers. I think that's why I won, to be honest with you. I think that's played a big part, and it was my kind of accessibility. Mm-hmm. Like, just, you gotta be yourself. Like, no one wants to see you go up there and be a jerk. Like, and be like, you know, I'm so great. Blah, blah, blah. No one wants that, you know? There's a difference between confidence and being arrogant. And like knowing that line and not crossing it, because you know, I think when people look at you and they say, hey, I want to go see this guy in concert, I want to go see this girl in concert, like I'd want to sit down and have a beer with this person, you know what I mean? Or well, now, you know, it's 15, so go have a glass of milk or whatever. But like, you know, I want to, like, this is the kind of person that I would support, you know? And when you can be honest and genuine and show that, people will catch on.
Lee, thank you so much for spending your time with us today. I know you have an extremely busy schedule, but we're very honored to have you here.
Well, thank you for having me.
Yeah, your Asian fans are going to be so excited that we got a chance to sit down with this in-depth conversation, you know, not just the surface stuff.
And thank you for everybody that, you know, shows their support. I love it in Asia. I love Hong Kong. I love you guys.
So. Oh, that's so sweet. Now, guys, do not go away, because we do have a surprise for you. That's right. Lee DeWise is going to be performing for you guys. A la acoustic, I guess you could call it, right?
Absolutely.
So this is going to be a very special performance. But before you go ahead and do that, can you please introduce to the fans what was your favorite performance on American Idol, and then we're going to show it.
One of my favorite performances from this season, there were a lot of good ones, but I think one of my favorites was Haley Reinhardt's version of Peace of My Heart by Janis Joplin. So check it out.
I make you feel like you were the only man. Well, yeah, now didn't I give you nearly everything that a woman possibly can? Honey, you know I did. Well, each time I tell myself that I think I've had enough. Oh, I'm gonna show you, baby, that a woman can be tough. I want you to
welcome back to Lee DeWise's Way to Idols. Unfortunately, our day together is coming to a close. Now, we've reached the top three finalists, and very, very soon, you guys and myself are going to get to see who they crown as the new American Idol. Now, before any of that, though, Lee DeWise is still here with us, and he's going to be singing a song called Earth Stood Still. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm Lisa. Enjoy.
We fell asleep under the stars, and you woke up in my arms. Oh, in the rain, and the rain, and the rain was falling down, trickled off our fingertips. The day the earth stood still. Another night goes by. Oh, without you. was I the erster stare? It's when I kiss your lips and I still get chills. Just thinking about this, you were melting into me, and I was melting into you. It was a kind of moment only time could kill. It was a perfect day, the day the earth stood still. Do you ever think of me when you're lying there alone? Do you know, or do you know what I'm going through? 'Cause I can't seem to let it go. When I kiss your lips and I still get chills, just thinking about this, you were melting into me, and I was melting into you. It was a kind of moment only time could kill. It was a perfect day, the day the earth stood still. I